Hello and welcome all my dear students. How are you all? I hope all my dear students are fit and fine, are taking care of their health and hygiene. My dear little friends, I am Rohan sir from Medhi English Medium School. I welcome all my dear second standard students in today's grammar lecture. My dear little friends, now if you were watching all the lectures regularly, you might be knowing that what have we done in the previous lecture? We have completed our English part and now we are moving towards the grammar. As you know that we move towards each part alternatively, grammar and English. Today I have brought this lecture for you in your classroom with the board which we usually use in the second standard. Why have I brought this? So that you get the change. You come to know how you are going to study once you come back to school. So, dear students, welcome again to the grammar lecture. And I hope that you are going to enjoy today's lecture. Now, what do you have to do? First of all, you have to take out your grammar textbook. Secondly, you have to keep the rough book with you. And thirdly, pencil, sharpener, eraser, whatever you need. So, I'll wait for a while time. I hope that you will be ready with that. And in the meantime, I'll give the heading here. I hope that you also will give the heading, today's date, subject. So, please start giving the heading in your books. I hope, my dear students, you have started giving the heading. Okay, here I am going to write the subject. So I have written subject and standard. You also have to write the subject. Please write it down. And now, what is the today's topic? Today's topic is preposition. What is the topic? Preposition. So please give the heading. This is the chapter which we are going to start. I'm going to explain you what is preposition. We will see a few examples. We will understand the concept. Then we will solve the exercise for the same chapter. For that you will have to be ready with the heading part. Now those who are having textbook, they don't have to worry about, they just have to take out chapter 14. Those who are not having a textbook, they will have to write each and everything written here. So, again, few more seconds I will give you. Give the heading. For those who are having the rough book, please give the heading chapter 14, preposition. I hope, my dear students, you have started giving the heading. Now, I am going to write few examples on the board which will help you to understand what is actually preposition. So, let me write the examples here. Now, as you can see, I have written three sentences, that means three examples to explain you what is preposition. Like I said, those who are having textbook, they can just refer to the textbook, page number 45. And those who are not having the textbook, I will give you the time. Please write these three sentences so that when I am explaining you, you will be able to understand it more precisely. Start writing these three sentences.
My dear students, I hope you have started writing the sentences. First sentence is, I put the keys on the table. Second sentence is, Eva went to the shop. Third is, the dog jumped over the fence. These are the three sentences.
Okay, my dear students, now you must be wondering. First of all, preposition word. We don't know what is preposition. We do not know why sir has written these three sentences. And what is the connection between these three sentences and preposition? So let me explain you very clearly. Now, if you see this word, preposition. Let me write here. Now, if you can see, I have written the word preposition again. And I have highlighted pre and position in the different ways. Why have I done that? Now you might not be knowing the meaning of preposition, but you must be knowing the meaning of position. Do you know what is the position? Yes, position means the place, some kind of place, correct? So preposition is the word that here means it will show you the place, correct? It will show you the link, it will show you the place. Now what does these three sentences has to do with this word preposition? Let me tell you. I put the keys on the table. I put the keys on the table. When did you put the keys? On the table. Eva went to the shop. Now, where did Eva go? Eva went to the shop. The dog jumped over the fence. From where did the dog jump? Over the fence. So, just try to think about the words I have highlighted, double underlined. Why have I double underlined? First of all, those who have not completed writing, please write these three sentences and then highlight the words I have highlighted. And then I'll explain you what is actually preposition in the sentence. I hope that you have highlighted the words and now you are writing it. Please make sure that you write down whatever is written on the board, each and everything. So that you do not miss out anything. My dear students, examples are also very, very important. If you want to understand the topic, you need to understand the examples and observe the examples carefully.
Okay, now if you can observe, I put the keys on the table. Eva went to the shop. The dog jumped over the fence. So the highlighted words are called prepositions. Why? Because the preposition is the word that shows relation of noun with other nouns in the sentences. Preposition shows the relation between two nouns, in short, in the sentences. Now you will say, sir, how does it show the relation? So, let me explain it to you on the board. How does it show the relation? So, my dear students, here you can see on the board, first of all, you have to find out the two nouns. Here, I put the keys on the table. Keys, table, Eva went to the shop. So, Eva and shop. The dog jumped over the fence. Dog, fence. So these are the nouns here connected. These are the nouns here connected with the help of prepositions underlined. I put the keys on the table. When did you put the keys? Keys and table are connected with on. Eva and shop is connected through TO2. Dog and fence are connected with the word over. So these words show the relationship between the two nouns. So if you want, you can also circle the nouns. I will wait for a while for you to highlight it. In short, preposition not only shows the relation between two nouns, but in very easy word, it shows the position. Whether it is inside, whether it is on, whether it is between, at, over, these are the words used in preposition. Okay, my dear students, I hope that you have done the needed, whatever was needed, you have done that. Now I am going to clear the board and we are going to solve exercise number 1. While solving, you will get much more knowledge about preposition. Please make sure you solve it with me. I am going to write the question, and as soon as I start writing the question, you also have to start writing the questions. Be ready with your rough book, new page. Those who are having the textbook, they also have to write down the questions and solve it with me in the rough book first. So I hope you all are ready with your books. I'll write the questions and I'll wait for you to finish writing the questions. So I'll give you sufficient time. There is nothing to worry about. Let us give the heading. Now, what do you have to do in exercise number 1? What do you have to do? I will write the sentence and you have to find out preposition in the sentence. Okay, so let's get started.
Number one, the bus fell on the floor. Number two, she watched the sunset. She watched the sunset from the window. She watched the sunset from the window. Number three, Sumit is going to the market. Number four, see students, I am going to write only four questions at a time, so that you will be able to write down in the lecture with me, and slowly you have to write down with good handwriting. My uncle laughed at our jokes. Now please write down the questions and then we will solve it.
So my dear students, I hope that you are writing the questions. Number one, the vase fell on the floor. Number two, she watched the sunset from the window. Number three, Sumit is going to the market. And number four, my uncle laughed at my jokes, at our jokes. So these are the four questions at first I have written. So I hope that you have started writing the questions. Four questions are there I have written, and if you have started writing just when I started writing, then you should have finished writing the questions by now.
So my dear students, I hope that you have finished writing the questions. If not, you can continue writing. By the time, I am going to explain you here what is the preposition and why. Now, if you look at the first sentence, the vase fell on the floor. Where did the vase fell? On the floor. On the floor. So on shows the position. The word O and on shows the position, right? So on here is preposition. Number two, she watched the sunset from the window. She watched the sunset from the window. So here from shows the position. That is why from is preposition. Number three, Sumit is going to the market. Sumit is going to the market. Again, to shows the place. That is why to is preposition. Number four, my uncle laughed at our jokes. So at shows again the position on which the uncle laughed at jokes. So please write the answers. You have to circle the preposition. So I have circled the preposition.
I hope, my dear students, you have started writing the answer here. You just have to highlight the answers, circle the preposition. The vase fell on the floor. On shows the position. Moreover, it shows the relation between floor and vase. Vase is flower vase, on which, in which you keep the flowers. Second sentence, she watched the sunset from the window. So from shows the relation between sunset and window. Number three, Sumit is going to the market. Here Sumit and market's relation is shown by TO2. And number four, my uncle laughed at our jokes. So uncle and jokes relation is shown by AT. So preposition not only shows the position but also the link between two nouns in the sentence. I hope you are highlighting the answer in the way I am doing it.
Now, my dear students, I am going to clear the board and write last two questions. Question number 5 and 6 I will write. Okay. Number 5. The pens are in the drawer. The pens are in the drawer. Number 6. The car is parked near the gate. Okay, we will solve these two for the day and then we will end the lecture. So please start writing these two questions.
Two more questions I have written. The pens are in the drawer, number 5, and number 6, the car is parked near the gate. Now students, I hope that this is pretty easy for you to solve it. You have two criteria to check to know whether it is preposition or not. First, it should be linked between two nouns. Second, it should show the position. Okay, so let me write the answers now.
I hope you have written these two questions. If you have not written, there is nothing to worry about. You can watch the video lecture again from the YouTube. And you can write the questions, complete the question. Even I am going to send you the PDF of grammar textbook. Please complete writing the question. Now, the pens are in the drawer. Where are the pens? In the drawer. So, in shows the position, right? In the drawer. The car is parked near the gate. Where is the car parked? Near the gate. So these are the answers. Please write out the answers. Highlight the answer and you also have to circle it with pencil properly.
My dear students, I hope that you are writing the questions properly. Sufficient time is given to you to write the questions. See, the pens are in the drawer. Now here it shows the relation between the pen and the drawer. though it may not be the proper noun, it may be the common noun. The name of the pen is not given, for example. If it was given that the Sparker or any Jello pen, then it is a proper noun. But here it is common noun, but you only have to see whether the noun is there or not. And preposition should show the position and the connection between the two nouns. Similarly, the car is parked near the gate. So gate and car, they are linked with N-E-A-R, near. Moreover, near even shows the position, somewhere near the gate. So in many ways in our English grammar, preposition is useful. If you learn it properly, if you get the mastery in it, you will never make any grammatical mistake, even in speaking or in writing. Okay, my dear students, so here I end my today's lecture. Today you have understood what is preposition. I wrote few examples which were then in your textbook itself, and we have done the exercise 6 sentences. Now your homework is to try to solve the other sentences too, so that you will come to know how much you understood and how many times more you need to watch the lectures. Have a nice day. Goodbye.